Hi everyone, I am Dr. Kavita Deshmukh. Today I will give you a first lecture that is on a psychology. So all the student, please subscribe this channel and also press on the bell icon. So you will get the notification of new updated videos on your mobile. So let us start to our lecture. In this lecture, we will see the meaning of a psychology, also the definitions of a psychology, and next part, that is the types or a different subfields of a psychology. So guys, firstly we start with a meaning. What is the psychology? The psychology, it is the word derived from a Greek root, that is it's have two Greek words. First one, it is the psyche, meaning it's a soul, and the next word, that is the logos, that means a science. So the psychology is a study of a soul or a science of a soul. So the psychology, it is the scientific study of mind and the behavior, or the psychology, it is a scientific study of mental and a behavioral process. So first we say, what is a mental process? The mental process, that refers to all the internal and covert activity of our mind, such as thinking, feeling and remembering. Also, it is a scientific study because to study the behavior and mental processes. The psychologist use the scientific method for understanding the more preciously and accurately. And the behavioral process means that includes all our outward and overt actions and reactions, such as the verbal and facial expressions and movements. So this is the meaning of a psychology. The next part, the definitions of the psychology. In that, first we see the definition which is given by the R.S. Woodworth. He defines the psychology as the science of activities of the individual. The next definition which is given by the William James in 1890. He defines psychology as the science of a mental life, both of its phenomenon and their conditions. Also, another scientist, that is J.B. Watson, defined psychology is the science of a behavior. So friends, this is all the definitions of a psychology. So next part, that is the types or a subfields of a psychology. In the field of psychology can be understood by the various subfields of a psychology. So the psychology have a wider scope. In the different field, psychology is used. So we see the different types of the psychology. First subfield, that is the physiological psychology. In the physiological psychology, the most of fundamental sense, human being are a biological organism, and psychological functions and the structure of our body work together to influence our behavior. So the biopsychology is the branch that specializes in the area. So biopsychologists may examine the way in which specific sites in the brain which are related to the disorders such as Parkinson's disease, or they may be try to determine how our sensation are related to our behavior. So guys, this is the first field, that is the physiological physiological psychology. Then next field, that is the developmental psychology. In the developmental psychology, the studies are with respect to how people grow and change throughout their life, from parental stage through childhood, adulthood and old age. The developmental psychologists work in a variety of settings like colleges, schools, healthcare centers, then business centers, government and non-profit organizations, etc. They are also very much involved in the studies of the disturbed children and advising parents about helping such a children for better living. So, this is the developmental psychology. Then, next type, that is the personality psychology. This branch helps to explain both consistency and change in a person's behavior over time, from birth till the end of life, through the influence of parents, then siblings, playmates, school, society, and a culture. Also, it studies the individual traits that differentiate the behavior of one person from the another person. Then, next type, that is the health psychology. In the health psychology, the psychologist focused on a health maintenance and promotion of behavior related to good health, such as exercise, health habits, and discouraging unhealthy behaviors like smoking, drug abuse, and alcoholism. So, the health psychologist work in a healthcare setting and also in a colleges and universities where they conduct a research and they analyze and attempt to improve the healthcare system and formulate the different healthcare policies. Then, next type, that is the clinical psychology. So, clinical psychology, it deals with the assessment and intervention of the abnormal behavior. In the clinical psychology, the psychologists are employed in hospitals, clinics, and private practices. And they often work closely with the other specialists in the field of mental health. So, in this clinical psychology, it is happened. Then next type, that is the counseling psychology. In the counseling psychology, it focuses on primarily on educational, social, and career adjustment problems. And counseling psychologists advise to students on effective study habits and kinds of job they might be best suited for, and provide help concerned with mild problems of social nature and strengthen healthy lifestyle, economical and emotional adjustments. Then next type, that is the educational psychology. In educational psychology, psychologists are concerned with all concept of education. This includes the study of motivation, intelligence, personality, then use of rewards and punishments, then size of the class, also expectations, the personality traits and the effectiveness of the teacher, then student-teacher relationship, also the attitudes. These are the different fields in which psychologists are study or do research. Then next field, that is the social psychology. In this psychology, the studies the effect of society on the thoughts, feelings and actions of a people, and social and environmental factors affect the way we think, say and do. So the social psychologist conduct the experiment to determine the effect of various groups, group pressures and influence on the behavior. Then next type, that is the industrial or organizational psychology. The private and public organizations apply the psychology for management and employee training. Also, supervision of personnel, improve communication within the organization, and counseling employees. Also, for reducing the industrial disputes, the industrial or private or public organizations use this psychology to study all these things. Then, next part, that is the experimental psychology. It is the branch that studies the process of sensing, perceiving, learning, thinking, etc. by using the scientific methods. And the outcome of the experimental psychology is, we know, we call the cognitive psychology. And in the cognitive psychology, we focus on the studying higher mental processes, that including the thinking, knowing, reasoning, then judging and decision making. So guys, this is the different types or subfields of a psychology.